You're ready to receive instructions, obey my commands, protect yourself at all times, touch gloves, God bless us.
There you see Sparkle Lee as the third person in the ring. One can only hope that she will be the third person in the ring for the main event later tonight with Katie Taylor and Amanda Serrano. Don't have that information privy to us yet, but if she is here, it's likely to happen. But right now, Reshat Mati looking to go to work in the big room here at Madison Square Garden. Mati in the all-black trunks. Joe Eli Hernandez in the black trunks with the gold trim. This is eight rounds. Two welterweights.
Keep a lookout for the hand speed of Reshat Mati. He's got very quick hands, sharp jabs, and he's got a killer left hook to the body.
Fast hands, fast feet. Quick and smart young pro. Had that fight in Milan back in October. The movement there. He was saying he didn't have a hard time against Baranov, but he had a hard fight. What's the difference, you think, between those two?
Well, you can have stylistically have the guy figured out, and you can be in control, and you can have a competitive one-sided fight in which the fight is difficult because the opponent is just a tough guy and he's there and he's making you stay on your P's and Q's, but ultimately you win the fight easy.
Like we mentioned, kind of a question mark with Joe Eli Hernandez, and he might have woken up the Albanian Bear with that rabbit punch. 12-1 for Hernandez, 10 knockouts, 8 straight fights though in Mexico. He's won 10 straight overall. And you just wonder about the quality of opponent below the border. We have a great example. Our last show in the U.S. in San Diego, Mark Castro taking on Julio Madera. Madera was a bit of an unknown. Ultimately, Castro came out on top. He outboxed Madera, but Madera was very strong, very powerful, only knocked Castro down in the third round of that last fight.
Yeah, you have to look past the numbers when you're looking at opponents and you're looking at records, because there are guys out there with 500 records that'll beat some of the top guys in division, so you got to be careful.
We will see Mark Castro in action next week on the undercard in Las Vegas. Canelo Alvarez going up against Dimitri Bivol, his own pay-per-view. Here, Reshat Mati getting his timing under him. Lightning quick jabs. And step it aside.
Reshat looking very sharp right now. Doing a good job of picking his spots, utilizing his jab, using his movement. Oh, good counter there with a left hand over the top.
Going on the back foot, no less.
Great first round.
Fans liking the extra talking at the end of the first round.
You know, I'm gonna go as far to say that Hernandez, either his record is padded, or he was kind of playing it slow in the first round, because I did not see much at all.
We see Mati's trainer, Arleano Sosa. Cut man Sergey Korchinski, his father, Adrian in his corner as well. And it's been Adrian from a very young age with Reshat, driving him over the Verrazano Bridge, back and forth from Brooklyn to Staten Island, training for Muay Thai and kickboxing and boxing. Ultimately, he enters the pro ranks here with the Sweet Science as we begin round two. I think Mati wanted to come in there to touch gloves after getting the discussion from Sparkle Lee. Hernandez opting not to.
The speed difference is very apparent between these two. Reshat Mati much quicker in the feet and in the hands.
jab comes in like a bolt of lightning.
Mm.
Good combo for Mati. Touching up the body.
Great body shots. I would like to see more of that. I think he can really get him out of here. I agree.
Yeah, I mean, Hernandez does look soft in the midsection. It would be a good idea to focus on that.
Mati catching a rhythm here in round two.
And like I said from the beginning, Mati does have a good left hook to the body.
There's another left hook down the chute.
Perfect.
And another. Hernandez with the showmanship. But we always know no means yes here in boxing.
I like how Reshat's not getting greedy. He's still using the jab. He's throwing the right hands up top, setting up that body shot.
I like the energy he's giving in the second round. It's only the second. He has my attention.
Mati looking for the timing.
Now, Mati might be letting him off the hook right now. It doesn't look like Hernandez wants to do anything.
Those recent flurries have slowed down Joe Eli Hernandez even more here in round two. Another snap jab for Mati. One-two combo. Reshat Mati, his third pro fight at MSG. Again, first time in the big room. Hernandez coming back with a couple of counters, but another behind the head.
Mati's doing a good job of using that right hand to time Hernandez as he comes in, chopping the straight right hand over the top.
Two-punch combo, both punches landing. Mati just has the smarts about him. When there's the slightest hint that he could potentially fall into trouble, quickly throws up the puck, reaches the distance, angles out of the corner. Sound ending to round two.
Here we see Mati using the jab, staying very sharp, maintaining distance, and capitalizing on the difference in hand speed. A little bit of jibber-jawing between the two of them that round.
I make that face too when I land a great jab, that ooh face.
And Reshat Mati said he respects Hernandez's opponent's knockout resume. And he said it doesn't matter where they occurred. You can't downplay that. He said his goal is to get Hernandez out of his comfort zone and have him defeat himself. But I think Reshat Mati has a better understanding after just one round, let alone two rounds, of Hernandez's ability. As we go to round three here at MSG on Before the Bell, Reshat Mati, Joe Eli Hernandez. Mati looking strong, smart, and it feels like it's only a matter of time before some power sets in as well for Reshat Mati.
Mati doing a good job of using his movement, his feints, and his jabs to really cut off the offensive movements from Hernandez. Good head movement there from Mati.
Another strong jab from Reshat Mati. His second eight-round fight here. Trying to go to 12-0. More and more of this room being filled up here as we move along on Before the Bell. Mati believes in a year's time or so, he'd like to at least have some type of regional title, some type of small title, but also be able to have the opportunity to fill up the Hulu Theater downstairs. He throws a right hand. He thinks he could fill it up.
Well, there are a lot of Albanians in New York. And he does have an eye-catching style, so it's not out of the question.
Big left hand to the body.
Definitely seems like the left hooks to the body have had the most effect on Hernandez thus far. Big deep breath in there from Hernandez. I'm surprised Mati is being as cautious as he is. I don't necessarily think he needs to.
Two quality punches to the body. Hernandez shaking, going backward a bit.
I agree. I think his aggressiveness just speaks for itself, and Hernandez kind of backs down to that aggressiveness if he comes forward.
And I mean, the speed difference is so apparent. Hernandez is just too slow, doesn't pull the trigger. Reshat's really just able to get off.
This isn't hyperbole. It feels like a double jab from Hernandez. Comes at a slower rate.
Oh,
man. Great counter. Now Mati just toying with him, punching with him. Watch it. Watch yourself. 20 seconds to go here in the third round.
Now, we haven't talked a whole lot about the weight, but I like Mati at this lighter weight. He was fighting majority of his career at 147. I think he's built a lot better for the 140s. Ooh. Hernandez tried to put up a little bit of offense in the beginning of the round. Mati, being the matador there, was able to make Hernandez miss and was in control throughout the round. The most damage being done by the left hooks to the body. There we see Mati digging down to the guts. But for the most part, it's a story about speed. Reshat's got it. Hernandez doesn't.
When you have that much speed within your own ability, how much slower does it look like coming from your opponent's direction? How slow are you seeing it? Or does that intertwine at all?
Sometimes when you're fighting a slower opponent, if you have that big speed advantage, it can actually throw off your timing. You know, you're expecting them to respond in a timely manner, and they don't. And then there's a gap in your offense. So you got to be conscious and aware of the rhythm of your opponent, even if they're slower.
I would agree with that. I believe, you know, with just like my fight 2 weeks ago, I kind of had the same, the rhythm was just kind of thrown off because she was a lot slower than I expected. So again, you have to find your rhythm and what's going to work for you. And sometimes it kind of slows you down in a
absolutely.
Way.
You can start fighting their fight at a slower pace. Yeah.
Right.
Hernandez coming forward moments ago. It's a cat and mouse game right now. Mati having words at the center of the ring with Hernandez. Digging down with that right hand. A minute into this fourth rounder. Or beg your pardon, this fourth round, it's an eight rounder. Quickness, where that left hand starts below the waist of Mati and then finds a clean home upstairs on Hernandez. Good double up with that left hand from Mati.
Mati's just picking Hernandez apart at this point.
And the right uppercut and then the left hand elicits such a weird reaction from Joe Eli Hernandez each time.
He literally just walked forward and then didn't throw a punch until he clinched with Mati. There's no offense coming from Hernandez. Mati looks like there he is in no danger whatsoever. I really think that he could just walk Hernandez down, let his hands go, and get this fight over with.
So do we ask ourselves, as you know, looking at the fight, do we want him to finish it? But as a fighter, sometimes it's just like, do we want to just go the distance, or can I really get this person out of here? Like, do you struggle with that?
No. If I can get you out of there, I want to get you out of there.
Good combo there. May have stunned Hernandez. He shakes it off.
Especially in my later years of my career, I was a lot more cautious when I was younger. Now I want to hurt people. So.
Big right hand from Mati, stinging Hernandez. Reshat Mati feeling it through four rounds.
I think he looks great. I love it. But I would like to see more. I feel like with a style like this, you're showing you're aggressive. You're showing the pedigree of a fighter that you are. Get him out of there.
Yep.
You know, show us that. Show us that you can get him out of there. Because right now, you know, you're toying with him, which is great. It's great boxing. But a lot of people just want to see you get him out of there.
Yeah.
Is there a difference here? Do you want to see him kick it up maybe another level or two? Or do you want him to go from 0 to 60?
I mean, he can go 0 to 60 if he wanted to. But again, it's choosing how he wants to control the pace, as we can see.
I think the style he's utilizing is perfect. But when he has his man hurt, I think he can step on the gas more. Just take more advantage of the opportunities. Like you said, he looks great. Everything he's doing is working. He's actually been able to hurt his man a few times. But there's that extra gear missing where I think if he steps on it, this fight could be over.
I agree.
And still not take any damage.
Right,
he's not going
right.
to hit at all.
And as a fighter, it's asking yourself, should I step it up another gear?
Mm-hmm.
I think at least for myself in my head, I'm like, okay, what gear are we on?
Yeah. Well, I think even Mati said himself prior to the fight, he wants to stop it. He wants to get the guy out of there.
Reshat Mati from the South Shore of Staten Island. MSG always in his backyard, fighting in the big room, the big arena for the first time. Fought as an amateur in the Hulu Theater, fought as a pro in the Hulu Theater. Here he is on the big stage. He said it. This is where the Knicks play. This is where Muhammad Ali fought. And he is looking to go to 12-0 and potentially pick up his 8th knockout as a professional. Mati throwing darts with those jabs. Hernandez throwing paper airplanes through 4.5 rounds so far.
Good awareness there from Mati on defense. See, so to slip and slide underneath those shots of Hernandez.
What we were talking about before is the fourth round came to a close. You think Reshat Mati, obviously all of his experience as a youngster, but still a young pro, do you think he realizes that? Does he need someone to convey that to him in his corner?
Sometimes it's either way. Either your corner's telling you or you're telling yourself that. Sometimes as a fighter, when you're fighting, your focus is just that focus. And sometimes your corner needs to say, hey, this is what we need you to do.
Hernandez just cracked Mati with an overhand right, actually, as Mati was going back toward the ropes.
That was Hernandez's cleanest punch of the fight so far.
Oh.
A left hand to the body by Mati, and a quick clench from Hernandez.
Heard that one all the way up here.
I heard that. Yeah. I heard that one.
He's kind of leaning toward that right side. Mati kind of knows where he has him right now, close to a bear trap. This may be it. This may be the moment where Mati could try and press in a little bit further.
That is one thing.
Another right hand.
He does lead with his head quite a bit, so Mati could be cautious of that. They did have a couple head clashes that Mati's been complaining to the referee about.
Mati, Hernandez being vocal throughout this fight. And a big left hand, right cross combo. Another right uppercut for Mati as Hernandez comes in. Sparkle Lee trying to restore order here in the fifth round.
I always think it's funny when fighters have words during a match because we're allowed to punch each other in the face. So why not go to that? It's not basketball.
I agree.
Good right hand from Mati as Hernandez closed in. The
clean.
As Hernandez, he's getting the reaction that he wants out of him, and I think it's quite funny because he's doing what he's supposed to. But again, got Shadi Mati to understand, like, you're in control. Finish the fight.
Here you see Hernandez with some choice words talking to Mati. That's all well and good, but he's not doing much to try and win the fight.
Any Puerto Ricans in here tonight?
In his last fight in Milan, Italy, Reshat Mati fought Vladislav Baranov, but they fought before the doors to the venue opened. And it wasn't until about the third round where the doors opened, fans started to trickle in. And that's when he saw some Albanian fans and he heard the Albanian chants as well, and it instantly gave him an energy boost, he said. And that's where he kind of picked it up a notch, started using those uppercuts more against Baranov, and came away with a really decisive victory over eight rounds. The crowd's been here the entire time as he makes his big room debut here at MSG. People continue to file in, and they're catching glimpses of Reshat Mati laying the hurt down on Joe Eli Hernandez here.
You know, I could see how a fighter with a style like Reshat, how an empty venue would negatively affect him. He plays to the crowd. He likes to be vocal. He likes to be showy. So in an empty room, it might be tough for him to dig down and get hit that X level.
More gamesmanship from Mati. A minute gone by here in the sixth round. He has controlled this entire fight.
I will say it is good that we're seeing rounds out of Reshat, especially that he's still looking sharp, because he's coming down in weight. You know, he's a few pounds lighter than he has been in the past, so he's getting the rounds in. He's testing out those new waters.
All that said, you can't help but sense that the opportunity for an eighth knockout is there. It's been there. And Alicia, like you alluded to earlier in the fight, he has the chance to charge up a bit. Just seems like, at this moment, still a little bit hesitant. Still controlling every moment here of this scheduled eight-rounder. Jabbing on the move.
That's the thing, controlling every moment and still energetic, so there still is time for him to get the stoppage.
Left hand catching Hernandez again, and a big breath taken in by Joely Hernandez.
Yeah, the shots to the body are definitely the ones that are having an effect on Hernandez. Not so much. He's taking the head shots quite well throughout, whether they're jabs or right hands, but the left hooks to the body have definitely been leaving a mark.
Streaks a left hand cross as Mati along the ropes. 10 seconds to go here in the sixth. Now lunging forward, Hernandez. Now Mati was getting upset and voiced his frustration earlier about the punches behind the head. There he kind of just took it and said, all right, whatever, man. That's how you're going to play. You got two more rounds of this. I'll see you in the seventh.
Hernandez hasn't been able to muster much else up, so Reshat also stayed sharp, using that left hand, that educated left hand, with the jabs and the lead uppercuts, lead body shots, in total control.
You see matchroom chairman, Eddie Hearn. How long before he knows he's on camera?
Setting out his next tweet.
Yeah. Start of the seventh round here between Mati and Hernandez, scheduled to go for eight. Our featured bout before the bell, Austin Ammo Williams, Cordell Booker coming up after this, and then at 7:30 Eastern on DAZN, the main card, Taylor Serrano. Multiple titles at stake, two undisputed bouts as well, including that big historic main event here in Madison Square Garden. Right uppercut from Mati. Hernandez charging in more here in the seventh round.
Reshat being the matador once again, firing off two hard jabs and spinning off.
Joe Eli Hernandez kind of reminds you of that slow-moving video game villain who you have no problem getting around as you make your way to beat that level. That's where we're at right now.
Yeah, he's just plodding forward. He's taking the shots well, though. I mean, other than the body shots, he hasn't really been too affected by the punches from Mati.
Why do you think Mati's not taking advantage of something like that?
Again, I talked about the headbutts earlier, the clashing of the head. He could be concerned about that. It could be that he feels some of the power of Hernandez. And, I mean, none of the shots have really landed, but you can just tell when someone hits hard, even if they haven't hit you yet. So he could just be being cautious. You never know how somebody feels in a ring.
Left uppercut scrapes Hernandez. 1-2 from Mati. Stabbing jab, left counter from Hernandez.
A rare punch there from Hernandez.
Oh, big left hand. Hernandez feeling it once again.
Yeah, you see him bouncing. You know that shot hurt. I wonder if Reshat is aware that he's hurting him. Sometimes when you're so close, you don't see it.
I can agree to that. Mm-hmm. Until you go back and watch the fight, you're like, oh my gosh, I had him hurt
and then you're like,
a few times. Right.
Yeah.
How often does that happen?
A lot.
Oh, wow.
A lot. That's why it's good to have a good corner tell you.
I agree with that.
There's another left hand moments ago that have the same sting as the prior one.
Here from the UK, sir.
Here we go with the start of round eight. And I got to tell you, at times earlier in this fight, did not think that we would reach round number eight, but Reshat Mati in full control so far against Joe Eli Hernandez. Been frustrated at times, just like this example right here. Mini headlock, Hernandez getting some emotion out of Mati. Big left hand pumped by Mati. But the aggression hasn't been turned up full throttle the way we have seen from Mati in the past.
Yeah, he just hasn't really, it hasn't been that consistent. He has done it at times, but it just seemed like he let Hernandez off the hook time and time again. He's had him hurt. He's hit him with some big shots. But I haven't seen that concerted effort or pressure.
You hear that Albanian chant. Mati's starting to jump it around. With 2 minutes to go in this fight. Another rifling right hand to the body by Reshat Mati. Mati continues what he's been able to do over the first 7.5 Whoa. Rounds. And another...
Almost caught the referee there.
Yeah, another foul throw from Hernandez. Oh, terrific move on the feet from Mati. Looking to secure victory number 12 as a pro. Remain undefeated here in his debut in the main arena at Madison Square Garden, his hometown venue. He said, yeah, there's places like Barclays Center in Brooklyn, but no, there's only one Madison Square Garden. This is his hometown arena. He's been putting on a show so far. Big 1-2 combo. Both punches landing upstairs, the left and the right.
Now the crowd gets into it. It's a real nice right hand from Mati.
He has about 40 seconds to give this crowd something to cheer about even further. Good check left hand from Mati. As he talks Hernandez down.
I think with all the talk, he definitely could have used those for hands.
Oh, nice uppercut. Timed perfectly by Mati on the way in. Cracks Hernandez on the chin.
10 seconds to go. Rocket right hand once again
for
Mati. Hernandez
is just coming forward. Yeah. He's like, you know, we're here.
There's a bunch of ready Albanians in the back. Make some noise, buddy.
Looking like a clean sweep for Reshat Mati here at Madison Square Garden. And they embrace afterwards, him and Joe Eli Hernandez, with a lot of words and a lot of showmanship. As the rounds went by, in between all that, Reshat Mati looking very impressive. So you can check this bucket list boxing item off for Reshat Mati. Boxing here at MSG. He said the only other venue that he aspires to fight in is somewhere in Albania. He wants to go to Albania to fight a pro match. You guys have any venues on your bucket list still that you have yet to check off?
Definitely the MGM. They still do fights there.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Canelo's next weekend. Well, at the T-Mobile.
At the T-Mobile, yeah. I would say Vegas.
Okay.
With the crowd, like, being in the UK with over 10,000, I'm like, I want the bigger crowds and the venues that can fill those seats, right?
Yeah.
We're going to see a European invasion later on tonight here as the main card gets underway on the zone. Let's go inside the ring and get the final tally for David Diamante.
Ladies and gentlemen, after 8 rounds here at Madison Square Garden, score totals, Eric Marlinsky, Don Trella, and Martha Trembley all scored this bout identically, 80-72, for your winner by unanimous decision. He's still undefeated, the Albanian Bear, Reshat Mati.
Well, a clean shutout on the score.